The Trump Middle East peace plan is being unveiled right now in Bahrain. It is just phase one, the economic part, but still, it is a historic 40-page proposal to invest $50 billion into the West Bank, Gaza, and neighboring countries that would transform the lives of the Palestinian people. I-24 News anchor Nurit Ben is inside Bahrain right now reporting for Daily Dose.
Here in Bahrain on day one of the U.S.-led economic workshop, Peace to Prosperity, and it hasn't even begun yet. They're closing everything off to the media until about 4 p.m., trying to keep a really tight lid on what actually comes out of this conference. But about 7 p.m., Jared Kushner, senior advisor to President Trump and the man who's really leading this effort, is going to open everything up with a speech on the private sector, on how sort of private investment can help overhaul the West Bank and the Gaza Strip. And that's really the base line of the White House approach to what we're seeing here. We have seen delegates streaming in from around the world, Arab world, the United States among them. Who actually is here? There is Egypt, Jordan, Saudi Arabia, other Gulf countries. Most of them are mid-level delegates. At this point, the only one who is officially listed to speak is a Saudi minister of state. That's the highest level. And as you probably know, Israeli officials were not invited. The White House says that is to try to keep this not political, however hard that may be to do. Israeli businessmen are here. On the other side, there are the Palestinians. Nobody's here except for one man, Ashraf Jabari, a Palestinian businessman who I-24 News interviewed a couple weeks back. Palestinian officials themselves are boycotting this summit. They say this amounts to an attempt to bribe the Palestinian people and are calling on other Arab nations not to come here. So looking at all that, it could sound like there's really dead on arrival, this plan, as the Palestinians say. But that's not necessarily clear. Talking to some people here, they seem to be quite optimistic, actually, especially the business people who say this is an opportunity for us to do what we do best, to try to tell the political leaders, hey, just help us get out of our way and we can make some really big changes in this region.